Rufus stood at the subway steps, looking down. For a wonder, especially at this hour, there was no one on the steps. The steps were empty. He wondered if the man in the booth would change his $5 bill. He started down. Then as the man gave him change, and he began to move toward the turnstile, other people came, rushing and loud, pushing past him as though they were swimmers, and he nothing but an upright pole in the water. Then something began to awaken in him, something new. It increased his distance. It increased his pain. They were rushing to the platform, to the tracks. Something he had not thought of for many years, something he had never ceased to think of, came back to him as he walked behind the crowd. The subway platform was a dangerous place. So he had always thought. It sloped downward toward the waiting tracks. And when he had been a little boy and stood on the platform beside his mother, he had not dared let go her hand. He stood on the platform now, alone with all these people, who were each of them alone, and waited in a quiet calmness for the train. But suppose something, somewhere, failed, and the yellow lights went out, and no one could see any longer the platform's edge. Suppose these beams fell down. He saw the train in the tunnel, rushing underwater, the motorman gone mad, gone blind, unable to decipher the lights, and the tracks gleaming and snarling senselessly upward forever, the train never stopping, and the people screaming at windows and doors and turning on each other with all the accumulated fury of their blasphemed lives, everything gone out of them but murder, breaking limb from limb and splashing in blood with joy. For the first time, joy. Joy, after such a long sentence in chains, leaping out to astound the world, to astound the world again. Or the train in the tunnel, the water outside, the power failing, the walls coming in, and the water not rising like a flood but breaking like a wave over the heads of these people, filling their crying mouths, filling their eyes, their hair, tearing away their clothes, and discovering the secrecy which only the water by now could use. It could happen. It could happen, and he would have loved to see it happen, even if he perished too. The train came in, filling the great scar of the tracks. They all got in, sitting in the lighted car, which was far from empty, which would be choked with people before they got very far uptown, and stood or sat in the isolation cell into which they transformed every inch of space they held. The train stopped at 14th Street. Rufus was sitting at the window, and he watched a few people get on. There was a colored girl among them who looked a little like his sister, but she looked at him and looked away and sat down as far from him as she could. The train rolled on through the tunnel. The next stop was 34th Street. People got on. He watched the stop roll by. 42nd Street. This time a crowd got on, some of them carrying papers, and there were no seats left. A white man leaned on a strap near him. Rufus felt his gorge rise. At 59th Street, many came on board and many rushed across the platform to the waiting local. Many white people and many black people, chained together in time and in space and by history, and all of them in a hurry to get away from each other, he thought. But we ain't never going to make it. We've been fucked for fair. Then the door slammed, a loud sound, and it made Rufus jump. The train, as though protesting its heavier burden, as though protesting the proximity of white buttock to black knee, groaned, lurched. The wheels seemed to scrape the track, making a tearing sound. Then it began to move uptown, where the masses would divide and the load become lighter. Lights flared and teetered by. They passed other platforms where people waited for other trains. Then they had the tunnel to themselves. The train rushed into the blackness with a phallic abandon, into the blackness which opened to receive it. Opened, opened, the whole world shook with their coupling. Then, when it seemed that the roar and the movement would never cease, they came into the bright lights of 125th Street. The train gasped and moaned to a halt. He had thought that he would get off here, but he watched the people move toward the doors, watched the doors open, watched them leave.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.